So this is going to be the last part of our session, of our Easter session, because Easter is 2 days, right? Or am I wrong? Well, at least I've got 2 parts of the session for every day of Easter. And well, let's just hop into a battle maybe. I've seen battles against tryhards and my team is not ready for it. Fenelux is the only proper Pokemon on my team, in all honesty, and Electrode, that's what I've got. The rest is just... Well, the other Pokemon are just not good enough for PU and Aussie. But we could do it if he's in the right situation, but he hasn't been in that situation. Well, he has been in that situation, but I get Icicle Speared 5,000 in a row from a Piloswine, which is way too good for the tier. Okay guys, so what do you know? We've got exactly the same team. So apparently PU is all the same lately and they bring all the same Pokemon. So we'll see how it goes. The lead is going to be this, of course. No, it's not. It's going to be Mr. Mime. I don't know if I would... Should I curse up or not? I don't know. Let's just go for the waterfall. Dazzling Gleam won't do enough. The waterfall nearly does enough. So let's rest right here and let him... Oh, he might go for the sidekick. And that might do enough from this point. It's going to be a close one. Yeah, if he has a psychic, it will do enough. That means that my only possible threat for this guy is gone. Except... So hard to deal with this PU team. Yeah, there we go. Why didn't you go for that in the first time? Oh well, let's go into Easter Bunny and go for the quick attack. Maybe he might not see that coming. We'll see real quick. Could the Easter Bunny get a... No, it doesn't get a kill. Of course it doesn't. Wow, it does good damage. I didn't expect it to do that much damage. I could try and bulk up on him. I could try it. Shall I? Or shall I just go into my... No, let's just go and play it safe. There we go, wake up slap. Alright, I don't truly understand that one. But let's just go for the extra sensory. Yeah, why not? Let's just go for it. I don't lose anything. If you switched in this thing, it will probably die. Well, 8%, it might even live it, in all honesty. But if he stays in, the extra sensory might flinch him. I don't know if I'm faster. Might be, might not be. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. I'll be back when he picks his move. There we go. He goes for the Ice Beam, and that does not enough. I go for the extra sensory, which does not enough as well, but we'll see how it goes. So he goes for another Ice Beam. Let's just not get the freeze, okay? So we're gonna roost right here while he goes into the Substrika, okay? You're probably going to... Let's just go into my... Electrode. Yeah, let's do that. We should probably going to go for the Volt Switch. No, just for the Thunderbolt. Okay, that's fine. Your R Life Orb, so I could go for the Volt Switch myself. Or Single Beam. Signal Beam. Let's go for the Volt Switch. I am faster. Ooh, that's not very nice actually, that I'm faster. So we need to go into my... Oh, crap. Yeah, I was scared that was going to happen, but it happened. What shall I do now? Let's switch back into my Togetic and let this be the last... Let's this be a Death Fodder. See, from there, the Overheat won't do it. I'm sorry, you should have gone for another T-Bolt, in all honesty. But it doesn't matter, because now your moves are not going to do anything to my... There we go, a kill, nice. To my Togetic. So, you go into this. You've probably got the Stone Edge. Let's just get rid of you. There we go. Stone Edge hits. Doesn't matter. And I'm not sure how fast the Torterra is. /DD Torterra. Torterra is 65 speed. So, my Easter, I should be able to deal with it. Not totally sure. But I think it should be faster, right? I think it should. So shall I go for the freeze dry? I think I should go for the freeze dry. Ah, there's the Rapidash. Okay, that's a problem. Yep, the Rapidash problem. Yeah. I was tempted to go for the water pulse, but he could have also gone into the Poliwrath. So what should I go? What should I sack off? I don't feel like this is that important because the Poliwrath is down on low amount of health. So get the Flare Blitz off, get a lot of recoil plus the aftermath. That's good. That's very good. So now I can go to my Easter Bunny once again. Go for the quick attack or the bulk up, predicting him to switch out. What should I do? You know what? Let's bulk up. Let's be ballsy. He's got a Morning Sun. Oh no. Well, it's actually not that bad. Because now I can Earthquake. The Flare Blitz won't kill me. There we go. Nice. We've got a kill. We've got ourselves a kill. Which is very good. So now he goes into the Poliwrath. I think I should be faster. Right? So I could go for another Earthquake. And hopefully take him out. He is faster. Really? How fast is a Poliwrath? Well, I should have gone for the quick attack. Gosh darn it. Why did I waste it? But my ice cream should be able to clean most of it up from this point. Because this is close to dying. Yeah, Mr. Mime. Let's go into my flying egg. Take the Dazzling Gleam very nicely. And you will die. Ooh, this is gonna be a cool game. Nice, I like it. I like it. I underestimated Poliwrath's speed. I should have just checked it out. I think it is 70, base 70, and my egg is. Let's see how much. What's its. Bunnelby, yeah. Oh, Bunnelby doesn't have speed at all. I forgot about that. Alright, now we're in a bit of a trouble. Oh, no. Roos. Yep, he lands it. So now I have to go for the Ice Beam. Which should take him out. But I've... Oh, the Pillar Swine. That was not a good choice. Why do you take that so well? Oh, Ice Pillar Swine is so good. Come on. Really, Pillow Swine? Why you are so freaking good? I'm a Specs freaking Easter Eyes. Come on, Pillow Swine. I freaking hate Pillow Swine. Pillow Swine is just way too good. It's just way too good. A Specs Ice Beam. I know you're a thick fat, but it was super effective. No, it was not super effective. Right. Because he has the ice typing, but still. Should I have gone for the water pulse? I don't think I should. No. Alrighty, guys. We're back, and it seems like we've got a pretty Easter Eyes weak team. So let's lead off with Easter Eyes. It seems like kind of try hard. Of course, Raichu in PU. He is giving me some nice words, so I will give them back as well. So, looks like a pretty Ice Week team, so let's see. I can take a Ice Beam. Should I go for the Flash Cannon? Predicting him to go into his own... He's going to Volt Switch, of course, because that's what all Raichus do. I went for the Ice Beam. I'm not sure if that would be enough to kill his Fenilux. If he decides to go into that. If he goes into Pelipper, he won't take it. If he goes into the Stunfisk, he won't take it. And the other mons won't take it as well. So this is the only mon who can possibly take it, which is probably going to take it, because Fenilux is really bulky. Look at how he took it. Should have gone for the Flash Cannon, darn it. So he might be scarfed, and looking at that, I should go into my Sea Lord. Yep, definitely. There we go, Flash Cannon. I knew that was coming. So now I could set up a curse or just go for the waterfall playing it safe. He's probably going to go into this thing. So predicting that, I could go into my Electrode. Should I do that? Let's do that. Because he's not going to stay in, clearly. He's not going to stay in. So either he's going to go into that thing, but that thing doesn't like water type moves. There we go, there's Nigel predicting it nicely. So now I should go for the Toxic, predicting the Stunfisk to go in, to come in. So there we see the Pancake, we land the Toxic, which is a good thing. So let's go for the Taunt right now, because he's probably going to set up the rocks, if I might guess. So let's see if he's going to do that. The Toxic is very nice on that thing, so let's see the rocks. There we go, there are the Stealth rocks. Nice, nice, nice. So now he's going to go for the Earth Power, and I could go into my... No, that's not a good thing. Not a good choice. I should go into my... there we go. So he goes into the... Okay, okay, this is fine. I can take you. I can take you on. So let's Lead Seed. This thing is really good with Evilite, in all honesty. It's unfortunate that you can't run the health item. Ah, darn it. He went for it. So now I could Toxic him. Or I could go into my... I just have nothing for grass types, which is a problem. Or I could go into my... You know, let's go into my Togetic. So, okay, this is fine. I can deal with this. Let's just Flamethrower you real quick. And maybe get the burn. It's a 20% chance, so it's quite big. It's a little less than Skull Burns, but I don't even get Skull Burns, so the chance is not that great, in all honesty. So, there we go. He's going to Vault Switch. And I know that I can take that, so let's just Roost. Right? Am I right? Or am I wrong? This seems like it's gonna be a cool battle. My opponent didn't bring the most threatening Pokemon of the tier, which is fun to see. Venelux is definitely a good Pokemon in the tier, but people don't realize that for some reason. Let's bring this one a little bit more up. There we go. And see what my opponent is going to do. I will start the timer. He's just... Oh, alright. He was predicting me to do something else, but let's just Flamethrower again. We're in the same position. So let's just do that again. He's gonna go into Nigel. Alright, get the burn. Darn it. I know what item he is. He is the Rocky Helmet, I know that for sure. So let's just extra sensory. I don't know why not. Why are just not? Ah, knockoff. Darn it. Extra sensory doesn't do that much. But I can go into this thing right now because I know that he's just going to he's probably going to Roost from this point. And my Togetic is not really looking fresh at this point, which is unfortunate. Ah, darn it. This Pancake needs to be gone so I can Vault Switch in and out with my Fingermajigger. So he's going to Sculpt me. Don't burn me. Thank you. Thank God. Shall I Taunt? Predicting him to Roost? No, he's not going to Roost. I could just Vault Switch. He might predict me to predict him to switch into his Stunfisk and just stay in and go for the Roost. That's what I'm feeling that he's going to do. Ah, darn it, he just played it safe. So now I know that he's not going to set up his rocks, because you know he's just not going to do that. I know that because I've gone for the Taunt twice. So there we go, there's the Earth Power. I knew he wouldn't do it. So, shall I predict him to switch it to this thing? No, he's not going to do that, right? Right? Am I wrong? Am I right? He's not going to take it. Well, this is going to be something. This is going to be a situation, because if he predicts me to go for the Flash Cannon, then I could also go for the Water Pulse. No. Let's just go for the Ice Beam, playing it safe, because if he goes... There we go. I knew we would predict it. Cool, now I can Vault Switch in and out. Great, finally. Just safely, but I have to be careful with switching this thing in, because it's not at a great amount of health. So that's cool. Easter Ice putting in the work, of course. Like it always does. And now I can switch into this thing and just go for the waterfall. He is faster than me. That's clear. At how he switched me in. How he switched it in. So I should just go... I could toxic him. Or I could go into my Easter Bunny, but he's not going to take it very nicely. So let's just go play it safe, go into my flying egg. Focus Blast won't do it. He is special, good to see. He's Life Orbed, also good to see. And now he's going to switch into this thing or this thing. Furlis, he's a Furlis fan. He's not going to go for another one, right? He doesn't really have anything to hit me with. So let's go into this thing. Oh, alright, I think I can take you on. You might be scarfed though. How fast is Electrode and how fast is Venelux? Venelux and Electrode is 140. I should be able to outspeed it, right? There we go, nice. So, we've got a problem, but I can go into my Sea Lord, hoping that he would not go for the... There we go. Nice, nice, nice. Let's just go for the off launch, right? Or shall I rest? I could rest. I could predict him to go back out into his Nigel. I'm not sure what I should do. No, let's just off launch. He's not choiced. Okay, okay, okay. That's good to know. That's very good to know. Knowing that he is not choiced... I'm not sure if I'm faster though. How much did a Volt Switch do? Let's see. 41%. So I should be able to do enough damage to kill him with a Volt Switch at this point. And that means that if I get a safe switch into my Venelux, I should be able to kill something. But Venelux is not really fast at this point. Ooh. That is quite a problem. I can only switch it in onto a Pelipper. That's the only thing that I can switch it in on. And then I should just go for the... Yeah, the Iceman should kill it from there. So this is a really cool battle. I definitely enjoy this one. If I could win one battle, at least one battle in the session, that would be perfect. Please, Easter Gods. Jesus, please. No, I wouldn't ask Jesus because I'm not... I don't believe in God, in all honesty. Do you guys believe in God? I would definitely... understand if you would believe in it, but I just don't. I don't know. My parents don't believe in God, and I don't as well. Maybe there's something out there. I'm not sure. I do actually believe that people come back to life after they're dead. They don't stay in heaven. That's what I think. But he's taking quite long, so let's start a timer. Let's see from there. The Volt Switch is able to take him out, which is a good thing. And now, what shall I switch in? I could go into my Easter Bunny. Easter Bunny. Or my Paint Me. Let's go into Paint Me. He looks at the best amount of health. So yeah, let's do that. And if he switches in the my Tiana, I know that I can take a hit and just go for the lead seed. Maybe... yeah, let's just go for the lead seed. Crunch. There we go. Won't do it. Lead seed, give me back some health. Good. Oh, a lot of health back. Good, 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 good. This thing is so bulky. It is so good. So, there we go. And now I can switch into my... Alright. I could switch it to my Easter Eyes, but it is so risky. If he goes for the Volt Switch, he's clearly not going to go for the Focus Blast. No, I think I should go for it. Oh, it's so risky. Knock off. Yes, I take it. Oh my gosh, yes. Yes. Oh, thank God. Let's just go for the Ice Beam right now. Extreme speed. Oh my God, seriously. Wow, extreme speed Raichu. Lol, I haven't seen that in a while. Extreme speed Raichu. Wow. That means he's not Lightning Rod, by the way, I think. Right? Yeah, it shouldn't be. Well, knowing that, I could go into my Easter Bunny. Because I will die next time. Yeah, Easter Bunny, let's go. Let's set up... Let's set up one bulk up, because I think I can take it, and then go for the quick attacks. Because I should be able to take a Volt Switch. Might not be. Oy, this is gonna be harsh though. This is gonna be harsh. Oh, there we go, Nigel. Nigel. Nice. Quick attack or power punch? Quick attack, power punch. Let's just quick attack, see how much it does. Not enough. He is Rocky Helmet, which are most. He gets a crit. Don't really care, but now I can go into my. How much speed does Nigel have? Paliper. 65. Yeah, I should be able to outspeed it and go for the Ice Beam. And that means that he does not have any walls left, which is a good thing. I should have just gone. Nah, it's gonna be hard though. I took too much damage with my Vandalux. I don't know if he's going to sack off one of his pokes. I can deal with the Raichu with my Execute, as well as the my Tiana, but it's not a switch in, so yeah, there we go. And I might be able to deal with this thing as well, but it's gotta be close. So there we've got Furlis. I could just sack it off. There's no real reason. If he decides to set up or something like that, I am able to break that with the Ice Beam, which is very nice. So let's see how it goes. Right now, Red Meow. Yeah, this is quite important. Those turns, those last turns. I am in the upper hand, but he has a Pokemon which is quite down, and two Pokemon which have a lot of health. Two of my four Pokemon. Oh, all my Pokemon are quite down. I should run Dazzling Gleam on this thing just to have some stab moves, in all honesty, but I didn't, which is kind of unfortunate. But I can go for the Flamethrower on this guy, and I think that he doesn't have anything to hit me with, which is good. Definitely. I think my Togetic can win the game. I think it can. Although it does not have the Ephialite anymore. So it goes for the Sucker Punch, fine. Oh, he gets the boost. Fuck. I should not have sacked him off. I have to hope that he doesn't have anything to hit my Togetic with. Oh, no, this is not good. If he has just anything to hit me with. Oh, the burn. The burn, please, the burn. Come on, this is the most necessary moment. No, I lost. I should not have sacked him off. No, why am I so stupid? Ah, darn it, I should not have sacked him off. What a misplay. Ah, darn it. Why did I do that? I can toxic him. There we go. So, right now, I could toxic stall him, so I do still have a chance, actually. He might... Should I go for another toxic? Let's do it. Yep. Let's go. So now he is not going to go for a attacking type move. He's not going to go for the Sucker Punch right now, right? So now I can go for the Signal Beam. Right? Yes! I got him! Yes! Oh my gosh, yes! Oh man, yes. You should always go on with Sucker Punching. So, right now I can deal with the rest of its team. Oh my gosh, I'm still able to win this. E-Speed won't do anything. And I could just wish up. Knockoff. Ooh, the knockoff though. Shall I go for the switching to this thing? It's risky though. It's really risky. I have to do this. No, I don't take it. Ah, oh, this must have been so close. Darn it. Ah, oh, I just can't win with this team. Sorry, guys. I tried my hardest. And I think if I would have taken that, I would have had the game, probably. What? Ah, darn it. It was so close. So close, so close. I might be able to make it a 1-0. I'm not totally sure. We're gonna see it. Ah, darn it. This is a very long battle, but I like it. 38 turns already, wow. And it was not too much stall either. So I will definitely give this guy a GG. If we would have just brought a normal team, I would have won, but it doesn't matter. I hope you guys enjoy this. Have a nice Easter, everyone, and then I'll see you guys in my next video. Later.